Sussman Hall. Great to see everybody here, getting ready for our end of the year concert. The everyone received your programs when you came in, I assume. Wonderful, wonderful hall we get to play in here at Gussman Hall at University of Miami, my alma mater. I'd like to thank our administration for allowing us to be here. Ms. Scott, Ms. Fongyi, Mr. McCluskey, Mr. Telletman, Mr. Steele, and Mr. Kling. You guys are all wonderful for helping us make this happen, and I totally 100% appreciate you. What we're doing today is, like we usually do, is we don't want any of you guys to get bored, so we're going to do a little trade-off. We'll play one piece, and they'll play another piece, and then we'll play another piece, and then they'll play another piece, and so on and so forth. But inside your program, we will follow the order of our music that you see in for each ensemble. So each ensemble will be in that order. All right? And without further ado, I believe we're ready to get started with the show. So here we go.
Thank you. Administration, Mr. Kling, Mr. Steele, Mrs. Scott, thank you so much for being here tonight. This is the culmination of the year for us. This is also, for many of us, a last concert in middle school. I know how some of the parents here are feeling, or at least I can imagine how. Before we move on with our next piece, I want to explain that when we were in Orlando, I happened to sit in the same dinner table with these two sweet sixth grade girls, and they had
Hello, my name is Ivana Dimisa Diaz. Mr. Mack, this speech is for you. Mr. Mack has been in our school for over 25 years. He gives Gulliver a touch of color, brightness, and of course, laughter. He makes us feel safe, he makes us feel cared for and loved, like we are at home. We will always be your kids, Mr. Mack, and you always have a home here at Gulliver. Thank you so much for everything you have done for us. We will miss you next year. With that said, I would like to dedicate our next piece to you. Mr. Mack, ladies and gentlemen, I present Colors of Home.
Our next selection is something that we premiered last year at our weird concert that we played outdoors at Gulliver. And I just didn't feel like it was done its justice because it's such a beautiful piece of music and we commissioned this work to play, to be played. And so I want to give it a real premiere. This is our friend Robert Sheldon, who comes down and works with our students often. Wrote this piece for us. We commissioned him to write this piece 3 years ago, and it came to fruition last year, and during COVID, and we were supposed to premiere it so he could publish it. So we did the quickie premiere at the academy. I mean, at the middle school outside concert that we did, and it was hot. So I want to do it in a nice, beautiful hall with a beautiful acoustics, and so you can really hear what this piece sounds like. It was written, we both shared an evening watching, we were in two different places. He lives in Normal, Illinois, and I live in Miami. So we were on the phone, and we were talking, we were looking up, and I said, man, he's talking about this meteor shower going on, and he says, this is beautiful. I said, this is like a new beginning to me. And I said, that's what we're doing. We're coming out of COVID. So this is our new beginning. So here we are, Starfall.
Thank you.
Every year, these students in September audition for what's called All-State Band, Chorus, or an Orchestra that happens in Tampa every year in January. These are the best of the best of the students in the state of Florida. The band consists of about 122-piece members from around the state of Florida. Usually about 15 or 16 in a section. trumpet section, a trombone section of 12, a clarinet section of 32. So they're very large ensembles. So anyway, I would like to recognize one of our band students at this time that made All-State Band and played in the All-State Band in September. Unfortunately, he's been ill, so he is not here this evening, but I would like to recognize Sebastian Beltran for his wonderful performance. And we have a few more.
Can you hear me? No? It says it's on.
You can use mine.
And I would like to recognize two orchestra students that made it into Allstate this year, and I couldn't be more proud of Brooke Lowry. Please come up here. And for the second year in row, Enzo Paisano on the double bass.
Good evening. So something that's different from band and orchestra is chorus actually has to go through two auditions to get accepted into Allstate. They have to go through a musicianship exam, which is theory and sight reading, so they love that part. And then they get about 3 weeks to learn seven pieces. And then they're tested on that, kind of a blind audition. They get to know that morning what they're tested on, and then they go in front of an adjudicator who is recording and all that gets sent off. So, you know, it's a big process, so I'm very proud of them. This year, I had three students who were accepted and participated in Allstate. So the first student is a seventh grader, that's Thomas Kellogg, so congratulations. And then for the second year in a row is Kaveen Chainani, an eighth grader. And of course, the last student, she not only made it 1 year, not 2 years, but she made it 3 years. So congratulations, eighth grade, to Gabriella Selick.
As all of you parents know, we got back late Tuesday, Saturday night from Orlando, a festival called Orlando Fest. I'm very pleased to announce not only did all of these ensembles make superior ratings at district evaluations, they also made superior ratings and first place trophies at Orlando Fest. And the ensembles also include the jazz band as well as the chamber orchestra as well. So, on with the show.
months. So there are two people that I would like to introduce tonight who have been on stage all evening. And the first person that I'm going to introduce is Mr. Cooper McMillan. He's our percussion guy for the chorus. And we go way back. I've known him since I was a little girl, so I'm so happy to share the stage with you tonight. So thank you for joining us. And at the piano is actually my mother, Charlene Kasuth. So thank you so much for joining us tonight. And so I'm very happy to have them. And I hope you enjoy our next piece, Hold On.
Piece with the string orchestra. I wish I could say and introduce my mother on stage, but she is in fact on the other side of the world. However, my family here is Mrs. Gonzalez and Mr. Keating. Thank you so much for such a wonderful, thrilling, crazy, exhausting year. It's been a blast. I can't believe we're back at it, and it's been just the best team to be in with the two of you, so thank you so much. We'll miss you, Mr. Keating, next year. I would also like to take a moment to thank all of our private tutors, without whom this would be pretty much impossible. Thank you so much for everything you do with our kids. and the endless hours you spend with them teaching them their instruments. It's really, really helpful for us. Also, thank you all the parents, and thank you to our volunteer parents that have put together a nice reception outside. Surprise, surprise. During the intermission, thank you so much for everything you do and for all your support. And before we play this piece, I'm going to ask another student to come on stage and say a couple of words about what's happening with the last piece we're going to play. Please come up, Susanna.
Hi, I'm Susanna Sagun, and I've known Mr. Telemann for 2 years now. And I've noticed that he is the most loving, caring, and fair dean of students that a school can have. Without you, we wouldn't be the Raiders that we are today. Thank you so much for being there for us always, even on our Orlando trip this past weekend where we had so much fun. I also know about Mr. Telemann's passion for rock and roll, and because of this, we would like to dedicate our next piece to Mr. Telemann, who we will miss very much next year. Ladies and gentlemen, Bohemian Rhapsody by Queen.
Okay, so the cat's out of the bag. They all know that I'm not coming back next year. But I'm still going to get to see them. You should have seen the reaction in the classroom. You know, there's three grade levels here. And so when I told them that I was going to be the band director at the music director at the high school, all of the eighth graders went, yeah! All the seventh graders went, and all the sixth graders went like this. And I felt so bad. But then I looked at them all and I said, you know what, I'm gonna get to see you guys in 2 years and you guys in 1 year. But in the meantime, I have someone really special I wanna introduce you to tonight. Their new band director, Mr. Edgar Rubio. I know they're in good hands with you. We're gonna make a powerhouse, just so you know. All right. This last number is called Red Giant. And if you know anything about the planets, that's the most severe one of them all. That's the one that encompasses everything in its path. So we're gonna play the Red Giant for you.
As we wrap up the first half, I do have something I would like to share. This is actually the ending of a first half, I guess, era for us. I have my first graduating class from fourth to eighth grade. We're so lucky that in the music department, we get to have these students from fourth grade beginners all the way up to our advanced ensembles. And I have three students who have stuck it out with me the last 5 years that I would really like to dedicate this last song to. This last song is kind of a culmination of what, you know, we've done. I guess we did it 3 or 4 years ago, right? And it was on their request. So I hope you enjoy as our closer for the first half, four chords, and please afterwards enjoy our intermission treats. Thank you.
Don't stop believing. comes to me. I come from the land down under.
Down under.
Down under.
Red, white, and blue.
The funny things you do, America.
America.
Tell me
where you're going. It's so complicated. I see the way your excellence.
Too late to apologize.
Hope you all enjoyed the first half of this concert. This is about a 15 to 20 minute intermission right now, and there's some refreshments out front for you all while we strike the stage and set it up for the second half of the performance. We'll see you back in a little while. Students are all going to go downstairs and put your instruments away if you're not playing in the jazz band. Okay. show. The jazz band here, chamber string orchestra over there. We're going to do the same thing. We're going to go back and forth so you guys can get a little taste of a little bit of everything. I hope you enjoyed your refreshments provided by our parents. Thank you so much for that. And off with the show. By the way, I'm not playing because I need, well, I do need to. My lead trumpet player is homesick tonight, the one that received the award. So I'm going to play with the band so they have that extra, that lead trumpet sound, which is kind of necessary. All right.
So on this side of the stage, you see the chamber orchestra. Unfortunately, Chloe is not here with us tonight, so I also have to step in to make it fair for the ensemble so that Coco doesn't have to cover her part alone. These students have done so much since you heard them last at the winter concert. They came back in January and started preparing for their solo and ensemble adjudication in February, which they took part of, playing a solo piece, each one of them alone. Then they led our string orchestra at MPAs to superior ratings. Then we went to Orlando, and they led our string orchestra again to superior leadings, ratings. Plus now they are presenting their own program of music, so they've really learned four different kinds of program of music since January. I can't thank them enough for this. It's been just a wonderful journey getting to know you all better this year and working with you. I love you all. You've been so much fun to work with. You're full of personality, full of life, full of joy. You love each other, you love music, and I'm sure it's gonna show on stage. So let us play something completely different and opposite. We're gonna go back 300 years in time. Johann Sebastian Bach.
Our next piece is called Stolen Moments and features Josh Achenbaum on saxophone and was supposed to feature Sebastian Beltran on trumpet, but I'll play his part today.
Thank you.
This next tune has a really cute name to the piece, Gimme Samba Dat, with samba in the middle. And it is a samba, and it is written by a very good friend of mine, Chris Sharp, and he's a wonderful composer, and I think he's listening tonight online. So we appreciate your writing, Chris. You're a wonderful writer. Thank you. And this features three of our students. It features Griffin on the guitar. It features Josh on the alto saxophone, and it features Elisa on the flute.
Next piece, we're gonna swap instruments. The students taught each other how to play their instruments, so you see, just switching up. Cellos are gonna be violins and so on. Let's see how this turns out. I don't know.
All right, as you can see, this features, this is a feature tune. And it features our lead alto saxophone, who happens to be the only seventh grader in this band. Yes. He also received, because we were at the ceremony just Saturday, major accolades from all three of the judges, to the point that they decided that he would get the only solo award presented at Orlando Fest. So congratulations, Joshua.
Yeah, Josh. Yeah, Josh.
Without further ado, this is a family warmth time. I can guarantee you mama's going to cry after sunset. Thank you. At this time, I would like to invite all of my eighth graders up on stage, all of you. Right up here, up on stage. Come on, you can do it, all of you. I got a bunch of you right here. You're gonna get something, I promise. I'm not gonna make fun of you. Come on up.
Come on up, guys. All eighth graders. All right. Not just mine, I need the chorus and the orchestra.
Exempt, all of you. This, you know what's nice about this right here? You see all these guys that are walking over there? I'm gonna get to teach them next year. I don't know if they can stand it, but I have them for another 4 years. Believe it or not, that's gonna be 9 altogether. I don't know if that's even a nice thing to do to people, but you know, having the same teacher for 9 years. What? Anyway, I think we're going to have fun, though. I want you guys to come parade over here for me, please. Just follow a single line. I'm not going to beat you or anything. I'm going to give you something. I promise. It's just a token of our appreciation. All right? It's a little pin that goes in your... You can put it on your backpack. You can put it on your collar. You can put it on whatever you want to put it on. Doesn't matter to me. But it just says Gulliver Prep Music, and there are whole bunches of them here. Just grab a string and start passing them out. We have one for each and every one of you. That's a lot of eighth graders. You know, I promised I wasn't going to get mushy, but seeing all these eighth graders, I'm getting a little mushy here. This time of the year, I usually have to say goodbye to all of them, and I'll see them at the prep later. But this time, I get to say bye to them and hi to them in the same statement. I am so thrilled to have these students, all these well-trained musicians in our midst coming up to the prep school. Would you like to borrow my microphone? Not really. She does not want to.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. I'm sure. Thank you. All right. Thank you. This is beautiful. All right. So we're going to continue on. The jazz band has one more number, and the orchestra has one more number. So they're going to start with the orchestra first, and enjoy. Enjoy.
Thank you.
my final concert after 33 years. Wow. These kids called me the Jazz Police anyway, so our last number is going to be called the Jazz Police by Gordon Goodwin. We will see you very soon, I'm sure. Have a wonderful summer. Enjoy these beautiful children. And thank you.
Can you turn the microphone off?
You got to tell them we got to wait one more minute. One more minute. One more minute.
I have known Miss G and been in her class since the fourth grade. She has been a great teacher and a great mentor. And we have some gifts and some flowers for her because we love her so much.
I'd like to thank Ms. G for getting us through a challenging year like this and always putting a smile on our faces.
I'd like to thank Ms. G for all the hard work she does every day to try to keep pushing us to do better and better. I'm gonna miss you so much when I go to high school.
On behalf of all of the orchestra students, I would just like to thank Ms. Calloway for being such a caring and supportive teacher. These past 4 years, we couldn't have done them without you, so thank you.